Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. In this video we are going to discuss about the derivation for most economical circular channel. Okay, in this most economical circular channel there are two parts. First one is condition for maximum velocity and the second one is condition for maximum discharge. First let us see the condition for maximum velocity. Before going to the derivation, first consider the diagram. Consider the circular channel and some part will be filled with water. We don't know what is the height, okay? So consider the depth of the water as small d and the diameter of the circle will be capital D, okay? See, let diameter of the circle is capital D and depth of the water is equal to small d. Next, we know the velocity formula. What is velocity? V is equal to C root mi, okay? Here C is the Chi's constant. M is the hydraulic mean depth. Okay, hydraulic mean depth means formula for hydraulic mean depth is M is equal to A by P, area by perimeter. So substitute here, V is equal to C root A by P into I. Next we know the
area in perimeter
area
formulas.
A is equal to R square into theta minus sine 2 theta by 2 and perimeter P is equal to 2 R theta. These two formulas we got from flow through circular open channel derivation. Okay, from this derivation we got these two formulas. So if velocity is maximum, then d by d theta of a by p is equal to 0. Okay, this is the condition. If velocity is maximum, then d by d theta of a by p equal to 0. So what is it is in the formula of u by v, no? So u by v whole dash is equal to v dash u minus u dash v by v square. This is the formula. So this is u, this is v. So what is substitute this formula here, then we get p into dA by d theta minus a into dp by d theta by p square equal to 0. Then move this p square to this side, what we get? P into dA by d theta minus a into dp by d theta equal to 0. Consider this as equation 1. So now we have to find out dA by d theta, dp by d theta. For finding dA by d theta, so we know the a. So d by d theta of what is a? R square into theta minus sine 2 theta by 2. So right here r square will be like that. And what is the derivative for theta with respect to theta? So the derivative for theta with respect to theta is 1. So 1 minus 1 by 2 will be constant. So put like that only. For sin theta, what is the derivative? Cos 2 theta into 2. So I wrote that only, cos 2 theta into 2. And here 2 and 2 will be cancelled. What are the remaining terms? dA by d theta equal to r square into 1 minus cos 2 theta. Okay. So we got dA by d theta. So put this as equation 2. Next we have to find out dP by d theta. For that, we take perimeter P. d by d theta of what is P? 2 r theta. So take 2 r theta. Here 2 r will be constant. Look, so put like that. And for theta, what is the derivative for theta? It is 1. So 2 r into 1, which is equal to 2 r. Put this as equation 3. So now substitute these two in the equation 1. So what we get? Now substitute 2 and 3 in equation 1. We get p into r square into 1 minus cos 2 theta minus a into 2r equal to 0. What is p? P means 2r theta. Here a means r square into theta minus sine 2 theta by 2. So substitute those two values here. We get 2r theta into r square into 1 minus cos 2 theta minus r square into theta minus sine 2 theta by 2 into 2r equal to 0. So move this 2r theta into inside, we get 2r cube into theta into 1 minus cos 2 theta minus multiply these two. 2r cube into theta minus sine 2 theta by 2 equal to 0. Next, take 2r cube common in these two terms, we get 2r cube, if we take 2r cube common, what are the remaining terms? Theta into 1 minus cos 2 theta minus sine 2 theta by 2 equal to 0. Then move this 2r cube to this side. Theta into 1 minus cos 2 theta minus sine 2 theta by 2 equal to 0. If we move this theta to inside, what we get? Theta minus theta into cos 2 theta minus into minus plus sine 2 theta by 2. and here plus theta and minus theta will be cancelled. So sine 2 theta by 2 equal to, move this minus term to this side, theta cos 2 theta. Then move this cos to this side and 2 theta to that side. So 2 theta equal to sine 2 theta by cos 2 theta. Sine by cos means tan, no? So 2 theta equal to tan 2 theta. If we solve this equation by hit and trail method, we get 2 theta equal to 257 degrees 68 minute. Okay, then what is theta? 257 68 by 2, which is equal to 129 degree 4 minute. Okay, from figure, if we take from figure, what is CD? We have to find out depth. So what is CD? CD is OD minus CO kada. So I wrote CD equal to OD minus OC. Here OD is the radius of the circle, so I wrote R. OC we don't know, so we have to take triangle OCB. In the triangle OCB, what is cos theta? Adjacent by hypotenuse, so OC by OB. So from this we get OC equal to OB cos 2, OB cos theta. See, OB means radius, so OC equal to, finally we get R cos theta. So what is the CD finally? CD equal to R minus OC, R minus R cos theta. If you take R common, what we get? R into 1 minus cos theta. Here CD is the depth of the water, so I write D. D equal to R into 1 minus cos theta. From hit and trial method, we got the theta value. So if we substitute here and solve this, we get D is equal to 1.630 R. If we want in terms of capital D, so what is small capital R? R is equal to D by 2, means radius equal to diameter by 2. If we substitute it here and solve this, we get small d equal to 0.815 d. Next condition for maximum discharge. Again take that diagram, and small d is the depth of the water and capital D is the diameter of the circle. V is equal to C root mi, we know. Next, what is discharge? Discharge Q is equal to area into velocity, A into C root mi. And next, what is M? M means hydraulic mean depth, A by P. So I wrote A by P here. So if we move this A to inside, what we get? Q is equal to C root A cube by P into I. So next, what is the condition means here? If discharge is maximum, then D by D theta of A cube by P equal to 0. Okay, here this is the condition. Again, this is in the form of U by V whole dash. What is the formula? V U dash minus U V dash by V square. So I apply this formula here, so we got this value. And next, here dA cube by d theta means 3a square into dA by d theta. Again, this is the derivative formula. Okay, next, if we take a square common in the numerator, what we get means a square by b square into 3p into dA by d theta minus a into dp by d theta is equal to 0. Next, move this to this side, what we get means 3p into dA by d theta minus a into dp by d theta equal to 0. Again, we have to find dA by d theta and dp by d theta. So take a is equal to r square into theta minus sine 2 theta by 2. Differentiate on both sides. dA by d theta equal to r square into, for theta with respect to theta, the value is 1. So 1 minus 1 by 2 is constant. So for sine theta, the derivative is cos 2 theta into 2. So 2 and 2 will be cancelled. So dA by d theta equal to r square into 1 minus cos 2 theta. Again, P is equal to 2R theta. Differentiate on both sides. dP by d theta equal to 2R is constant. For theta with respect to theta, the derivative is 1. So finally, dP by d theta equal to 2R. Substitute these values here. What we get? 3 into 2R theta into R square into 1 minus cos 2 theta minus R square into theta minus sine 2 theta by 2 into 2R equal to 0. Multiply these two terms and these two terms. What we get? 6R cube theta into 1 minus cos 2 theta minus 2R cube into theta minus sine 2 theta by 2 equal to 0. Now take common 2R cube from these two terms. So what we get? 2R, if we take 2R cube common, 3 theta into 1 minus cos 2 theta minus sine 2 theta by 2 equal to 0. Next, move this to this side. 3 theta into 1 minus cos 2 theta minus sine 2 theta by 2 equal to 0. Next, multiply these into inside. 3 theta minus 3 theta cos 2 theta minus 3 theta plus sine 2 theta by 2 equal to 0. Then 3 theta and minus theta will be 2 theta. So 2 theta minus 3 theta cos 2 theta plus sine 2 theta equal to 0. It is minus term. So move this to this side. what we get?
So here
2 theta plus sine 2 theta by 2 equal to 3 theta cos 2 theta. Okay, if we take 2 LCM here, what we get? 4 theta plus sine 2 theta equal to 6 theta cos 2 theta. Okay, move this to this side. 4 theta minus 6 theta cos 2 theta plus sine 2 theta equal to 0. If we solve this equation by hit and trial method, we get 2 theta equal to 308 degree. Then what is theta? 308 by 2, which is equal to 154 degree. From figure, CD is equal to OD minus OC. Wait, I'll show you. CD is equal to OD minus OC. Again, what is OD? OD is the radius, no? So I write R. R minus OC means if we take triangle OCB, cos theta equal to OC by OB. Then OC equal to OB cos theta. OB is R. So finally, OC equal to R cos theta. I substitute here directly. So if we take R common from these two terms, CD equal to R into 1 minus cos theta. What is theta from here? 154 degree. If we substitute and solve, we get small d equal to 1.89 R. Then what is small d? Small d is equal to capital D by 2, no? So small d is equal to 1.89 into capital D by 2, which is equal to 0.95 d. So this is the depth of the water. This is all about most economical circular section. Thanks for watching, and please subscribe and follow for more videos. Thank you.